I got my face in my Tuesday. I wasn't expecting my face to be part of the action here today, but it's all gravy. You can see the frustration. But, I mean, the lights are off, so I guess I could put on, like, there. Now there's some light, but it's like, it's bothering me. Okay, wait, that's not enough. It's bothering me. It's too close to my face. More like that. No, that's not enough. Nope, sorry. Maybe the game will light me up once it, like, turns on. Anyway, what's up? More Last of Us. I'm dancing. I'm chilling. I'm horrible at it, as you can see. Drop a feather. Macarena time. More streamers should do the Macarena. It's the best. Alright. When we left off, I killed the biggest, dumbest fucking boss in video game history. Holy shit. Well, actually, I just watched it kill itself, mostly. Right before I went out on my apartment hunt. Which, I don't know, honestly, I don't know. I kind of feel like maybe... I don't know, guys. Honestly, I don't know. I'm not gonna lie to you, I'm not sure how I feel. Part of me wants to move out. Well, I can stay moved out because I left my mom's crib about a year and a half ago. But part of me kind of wants to go back home. I would save a ton of money if I go back home. But also, losing my freedom. I kind of like my freedoms. So we'll see, I don't know. How come, even though Ellie's background is pink and yellow, and Ellie herself is wearing a green and a blue combination, how come they blend in somehow and it feels like it's a scene? How come none of it looks like popping? None of it takes attention away from the rest? Because it's perfectly blended. Somehow they made it so that the dampness and the dankness and the darkness meshes it all together. And even as I did the turnaround, as if they knew, there's already a picture frame there so that Ellie can be framed on the wall because she's the person in this scenery. You see what I'm saying? Mastercraft, bro. Mastercraft. Let's do that again, look. I'm just going upstairs, boom. Something's behind Ellie, again. Are those little turds? Is that the sun chasing little turds? What the fuck? No, those are supposed to be worms. But they look like little turds. And that's a chicken eating worms, but it looks like the sun is chasing after little pieces of turds. That's what it looks like. That's exactly what it looks like. Naughty Dog, what the fuck? No, seriously, Naughty Dog, what the fuck? What is that? Holy shit. I swear, y'all don't be seeing this shit, but it's here, and it's awesome. A little weird. It's not even attention to detail, it's like... to say, like, I don't know how to make it more obvious that this game is like fucking incredible, you know what I mean? What the fuck? Hey, where'd you take that picture from? Well, Last of Us 2. What? That was in The Last of Us 2? Yes. Yes, it was. Like, it's so tiny and it's so dumb, but it's so awesome. Hey, I didn't notice this area last time. This is like the lounge area. This is where like the pro players would meet up. That's interesting. Like the low players and shit. That's a very weird view of the scene though. And then you got the... for when the kids play the smashes together or whatever the fuck. The Mortal Kombat's. A more casual fighting game. But no, my scene is much larger than this. And we're not at a regular arcade. That's not what I mean when I say bring back the arcade. When I say bring back the arcade, I mean... like, the actual arcade. Like, I want to chill with all the kids, but like, the idea behind it, you know what I mean? Like, all the games in one place, and let us fucking play, you know? And maybe add some beer, like the beer cades, those are dope, those are really dope, but like, it's just a bunch of the classic games, like, why not put Street Fighter 5 in there, you know? So the adults can chill and have a beer and fucking play some Street Fighter. Like, what's so bad about that? But, you know, whatever. Maybe I'm just a jerk. Cool. I want to go see the other arcade spots, but I didn't like really look through all of this stuff. Can I pick the ball up? Can I kick it? Oh shit, I can play soccer. I don't recall this being here the first time around. Oh! Wow, seems pretty heavy. I don't recall this guy being here either. Hey, I could've used you. I could've definitely used you. Was that there the first time around? Seems kinda crazy. Person just fucking... I think I would've remembered that. Did they already patch that in? I remember the turning. I remember this being here. Or were we just so fucking into it at the beginning of this game's life cycle that we missed something so fucking dramatic? Did we just fucking not comment on the fact that there's a fucking dead person right there on the fucking foosball table? Look at that shit. Dead as fuck. Mouth open upside down. What the fuck? I was just here and I didn't see this person. I was just here and I did not see this person. I guess I was so into the fucking Dance Dance Revolution that I didn't even notice him. That's crazy. Wow. Since I walked through the blood, there's a blood trail. That's crazy, dude. What the fuck? And I think the first time I ran in here was the same thing. I was so into the fucking arcade cabinets that I didn't even notice there was a fucking dead person. Right fucking there, dude. Just dead as shit. Now that's some masterwork shit right there. I'm gonna go back and watch my own Let's Play, just to see if I caught that the first time around. Cause that's crazy. Was I so into the games that I didn't even notice that there was dead motherfuckers right there? That is fucking insane, dude. Holy shit.
Finally. There.
Hold up a minute.
Okay.
Thank you. way, that was pretty far.
Fuck it. I can make it.
Wow, I forgot about this part. Holy shit, Ellie had to fucking swim for real. I'm not sure if I saw a Let's Player do that or if I did that the first go around. Oh, big jump. I don't think there's anybody here. I think I can just go for it. Because this is where you get the cutscene, right? So really the only motherfuckers I would have to worry about are like fucking nobody. There's nobody because Bear dies in a cutscene, right? So there's nothing. There's nothing I can do here. Like, I'm just gonna get to where I gotta get to. I think at most maybe I could rummage for parts, but like, it's not going to mean anything in a little bit because we're about to start Abby's chapter. I did it. I beat Ellie's part already.
What is all this stuff?
Really Resident Evil 3-ish right here. That part, very Resident Evil 3. And then climbing up this, so Resident Evil 3. I would rather that, like, in Ghost of Tsushima, when you're going up a ladder, you can just press up and you go straight up it. I would rather be fucking, I would rather stop and have to press X. I think that makes for a better experience.
Where the fuck are you?
I grabbed anything? Why not? Okay. It's not like it's gonna matter in a little bit.
Kill him! Back on that island.
Times has Abby risked her life for you.
She chose this. I'm not fucking going there.
Then don't! Go back.
Fuck you, Owen. Hands up.
Fuck you.
Where's Abby?
You're that girl from Jackson.
Tell me where she went. How do we know you won't kill us?
Give her what she wants and we're dead.
You guys can survive this. I just need her.
Bullshit.
Come here. Fucking get over here! Point to where she is on this map. And then you. It better fucking match up.
What are you doing?
She's probably dead anyway.
It is not worth it.
Stop!
We can talk
about it. Back the fuck up! Point to where she is. Fucking Christ!
QTE. I'm almost crying for Owen and Mel now. Almost. Yeah, she's pregnant as hell, bro. You kind of fucked up. This is actually a part I wanted to remind you guys of. I saw some reels talking about it. I wanted to bring it up. Excuse me.
It's all right. Come on, let's go. Let's go.
Everybody's saying how they don't understand why Ellie left her map. I heard somebody say that, and it's like, well, you didn't notice that the game clearly shows that Ellie left her map. In the tussle, in the struggle, in the anger, and there's the map right fucking there. So you can't really say, well, how'd she forget it? You forgot. Because they showed it to you, and you didn't even notice. I know because I forgot. I didn't even check out this side of the map. That looks pretty cool. Wow. Wow.
Mm.
I'd like to order one for... I guess it is. That's pretty cool.
It's not gonna work. It's completely covered in snow.
Nah, by the time we get there, this whole area will be thawed. Where are you going?
Needed some air. What are you guys doing up?
Couldn't sleep.
Come take a look at this. Thought is to head home via Ellensburg.
We're in Fall City by tomorrow. We're doing good. Hey. They got what they deserved.
But she gets to live.
Yeah. Is that okay?
To be.
I'm really not looking forward to going through Idaho again.
What you should be worried about is what Maria's gonna do to you when we get home.
Oh. We've been through worse. However, as I was passing through some ritzy section of town, I come across this necklace. It sparkles a lot. I think it's real gold.
You think it's real gold?
It's real gold.
Let's see it.
I know what gold looks like.
If it's legit, can we say it's from all of us?
Ha! You find your own damn bribes.
Tom is holding his head from the time Abby pushed him into the fence and then threw him off the shore or whatever.
How you doing?
Fine. Thanks for coming back for me.
My friend's problems are my problems.
You're such a sap.
All right, how about... My friends can't get out of their own damn way.
It's better.
Fucking headshot.
Stand up! Hands in the air, I shoot this one too.
Don't you do it, Ellie. Get out of here.
Stand up! Now!
Don't you fucking dare!
Shut the fuck up! Fuck. All right. Stop! Stop!
She already proved she's a hell of a shot with that thing. Just
toss
by getting
weapon.
That first headshot. She's a fucking
toss
headshot.
Toss your weapon! Fuck. I know why you killed Joel. He did what he did to save me. There is no cure because of me. I am the one that you want. Just let him go.
I could see why Ellie was scared after fucking popping
all my friends.
Jesse with a fucking headshot. And after
how
ruthless
and you wasted
she
it.
Was with Joel. She's a fucking crack shot and she's not fucking... And she's merciless as fuck, you know? She has no mercy whatsoever. Even after Joel saved her life,
Dad!
You know?
Dad! Dad! Come on.
In Ellie's mind, that's what she's thinking right now. Like, this chick is a fucking dead shot. She's a
Dad!
Fucking headshot at him as soon as he opened the door. No hesitation, fucking right through the fucking face. And she killed my dad with a fucking golf club. I could see why
dad,
Ellie was a little hesitant in that moment.
You can't keep doing this.
And it turns out to be the right call because Tommy lives in Ellie. Well, yeah, you know the story by now. Ellie lives as well. So, although, like, I understand why someone would be like, Ellie should have just shot it right there. She probably couldn't. She probably couldn't because Abby's a fucking dead shot. And the game makes reference to that too, which is something Ellie doesn't necessarily have a chance with, other than with her bow and arrow. She does practice her bow and arrow. Bernard is shooting, whereas Abby has a shooting range.
Dad!
Which, when we get to the stadium, I can show you that Abby has a shooting range at her disposal. So, like, most of the things that people, folks are calling plot holes, aren't really plot holes. It's just, like, it's stuff in the game that they missed, because a game like this is massive. You know, it's massive, and it's linear. So, you know, usually open world games are massive, so there's a lot of things you miss in the world.
1978.
But with this being linear, it's still massive.
Maybe I can get onto the roof.
So there's still going to be things you're going to miss. You know what I'm saying? It's just more than likely not a part of the world. It's going to be like a side quest or an alleyway or something that you didn't really take notice to.
Abs?
You got a little mud on you there, sweetheart.
So do you.
Where?
Right there.
Oh, ha.
You know, every time you run off like this, they give me shit about it.
Come on.
Believe it or not, they actually care about your safety.
These woods are safe.
Dad.
Abs. She's been hanging out.
Another thing folks are saying is that women don't have bodies built like that. And
she's due,
like,
any day now. We'll just check on her and then
Bro,
we'll
I'm
head
from
back.
Chicago.
I promise.
Let's just make it quick.
They call us the City of Broad Shoulders for a reason.
I've got my little girl to keep me safe.
Yes, they do.
How'd you know I was here? Owen ratted me out, didn't he?
He did his job.
How'd you get him to talk?
I asked. Hey, look what I found.
Oh.
No, the thing that bothered me about it, that I was like, that's bad writing.
If you promise not to,
like,
pull anything like this again.
Bro? Like, that's so fucking cliche. It's so fucking lame.
Why don't I believe you?
Oh, the two sides to every coin. Fucking lame. And, like, I didn't notice any fucking Let's Players talk about that shit.
Relax. You'll be back with Owen before you know it.
And to me, that's what I was like, that's bad writing.
Just... No,
that's fucking lame and cliche, and like, talk about the easiest fucking thing you can do to reference, you know, that there's two sides to the story. Oh, she collects quarters, like,
I see things.
Fuck, man.
Like the way you both try.
The easiest thing you could do.
Not to look at each other when you're around me. You get all serious. It's very cute.
I can't handle this.
And he makes you laugh.
That's because he's such an idiot.
I just like how he's extra nice to me now.
So, you're taking advantage of him?
Never. Abs, look. Fresh tracks.
Wait. This is just your sneaky way of giving me a tracking lesson, isn't it?
I would never. Is it working?
Smell
roses. Well, I mean, found you.
Yeah, but you cheated.
You do what you need to do to get it done.
You actually listen.
You have your moments of wisdom.
You have all the green and all the brown and all the everything in the world.
Let's
and nothing is standing
else.
Out more than anything else. It's all blended in perfectly. It looks like a real place. Nothing looks photoshopped in. Nothing looks splashed together.
See anything else?
Real.
Not yet.
That orange is dark orange. That blue is dark blue. You know what I'm saying? Like, even though those are contrasting colors, because of the leaves being black and because of the blue elephant being somewhat black, it feels like it should be together, even though it shouldn't. You see how, like, there's shadows in the elephant, and then there's shadows in the orange with the leaves? That's why it looks so beautiful. And at the same time, so well made. It doesn't feel out of place. Because everything is blended to the littlest fucking detail.
Abs, check it out. She already gave birth.
Is that the placenta?
Sure is.
Ew.
And look. Two sets of tracks.
Dad?
It's her. Let's go.
It doesn't sound good.
Abs. Come on.
Dad, wait. What if they're infected around?
This area is clear.
You know they roam.
You brought your gun, right?
Of course.
Then I'm not worried. Oh, shit. Abs.
What? Oh, my God.
We've got to cut her loose.
And then, like, that... The seat where the light is shining directly on it to bring your eyes towards it, but not in a way that makes you want to vomit. You know what I mean? It's not overly bad.
Abs, come here.
And it feels and looks natural, even though it's not.
I'm gonna hold her.
Okay.
Calm down.
Doc, are you around here?
Over here, Owen. What? Hey, get over here and help me hold her. We need you back up. Owen! Hold her!
Like, you could take a still frame of any one of these shots. And it's completely in sync. Completely beautiful. Right. Nothing necessarily stands out.
Yeah.
All
right. Get in there, Abs. Steady. Fuck.
It isn't necessarily that the graphics
are. We got it. Hey, wait,
amazing.
Dad! What's going on?
It's that the colors are done in such a way so that it kind of tricks your eye.
We did good back there. Doc, that girl showed up. What girl? The one Marlene keeps talking about. They found her in the tunnels. She has an old bite mark on her arm. No signs of infection. That can't be. They're already running tests on her, but you gotta get down there.
Nothing is too bright. You know, everything is somewhat damp.
Come on.
It looks like a fucking work of art. In every frame, it doesn't look like a copy-pasted video game. It never looks like a video game.
With the brain. There's no other option.
There has to be some other way.
There's no way to remove the specimen without destroying the host.
The host? She's a child, not some petri dish.
You think I don't... I'm aware of the situation.
And you're okay with killing her?
No, I'm okay with developing a vaccine that'll help save millions of lives. How many fireflies have died for less?
That was their choice. Are you asking me? Or are you telling me this is how it's gonna be?
I am begging you to buy in.
And what if this was Abby?
Look, everything that we've been fighting for, all the sacrifices, all the horrific...
777, check.
All of that. Is justified with this one act.
If this was your daughter, what would you do?
Facial expressions are on another level.
Abby,
buy some dinner.
Thank you, sweetheart.
Even the fucking geisha there in the back, not bright. Look, should have been bright because of the colors that are associated with Japanese geisha. Not bright. Damn. Blending into the rest of the world.
I'm gonna go tell Joel.
Why?
He traveled across the country with her. He has a right to know. Good luck with your surgery. You're doing the right thing. If it was me, I'd want you to do the surgery.
I think the lows of this game are extremely low, and that's what stuck with a lot of players, which is ultimately pretty sad. Because a lot of gamers are like really emotion based, and if they're not having fun like all the time, then they hate the experience. But it's like, what about when Joel and Ellie were at the fucking museum? You know what I mean? Like, there was good moments in this game too. They just choose to forget them or not pay attention to that.
Is he still in the fucking building?
Is it?
Abby.
No!
Abby, don't look!
Dad! Dad! No! No!
No! I feel like that grimace may have been a little too much. Now it's fine, but like, at the beginning of it, it was a little... I don't know. Like, the full frontal teeth, I don't know.
Get up! Joel, fucking get up! Please stop! Please don't shoot! Joel, please get up! No! No! No!
And as sad as this scene is, I can say I hugged the fuck out of my dad for Father's Day. Hugged the fuck.
I'll fucking kill you!
Whoa, what are you doing?
And if
Lenny, no.
You
no,
don't
no,
have we're here a for father,
that's it. It's too risky to leave them alive.
Hug the fuck out of your mom.
He's right.
If you don't have a mother figure, I hope you hug the fuck out of your guardian angel.
We killed them. We're no better than he was.
Because you still have those.
They didn't do anything
figures,
wrong.
You know?
Yeah, look at my face.
Parents.
Fuck your face. You should have been guarding the upstairs like I told you to. Move! Back up.
So if this game taught you anything,
calm down.
You should be too.
Shoot me?
Stop!
Be thankful for what you do have.
We're done.
I hugged the shit out of my dad that Father's Day. Holy shit. I don't think I ever hugged him so hard out of my pops. I'm so lucky and blessed to have my dad with me. Even though, you know, when we were younger.
Abby.
But everyone makes mistakes, you know, whatever.
Easy.
I'm Mexican.
Yeah, just...
Trust me, when I was growing up in the Mexican
up?
Neighborhood...
Been searching everywhere for years. We've been called up. Isaac wants us at the front.
What? Are you serious?
I'm afraid so. We should hustle.
We're leaving now?
Yes. Vamonos.
Okay. Fuck my neck.
Whoa.
Hey, thanks for giving me their room last night.
Yeah, who was it this time? That cook chick?
Nah, the weather chick.
So they have a library.
Oh, the scientist. Nice.
She's a little too excited about her job. Talk my ear off about some storm and I don't know.
Worth it, though?
Oh, absolutely. I can die happy now.
You should. You're never
they have a gym.
I keep thinking the same thing.
Where they're training in boxing, weightlifting. They probably have books on how to get the proper gains, which explains why she's fucking built like that. See water bottles there. That explains why she's so swole. The library plus the gym equals swole. Now, I know some of my detractors would say, well, what about, like, food and shit like that? Like, you would need certain, you know, nutrients or whatnot. Like,
hello, Miss Potts.
And here's the school for the babies. Look at the babies.
Her too.
A gentleman never tells.
Man, he's such a fucking player.
Wow.
Here we see they have plant classes. Classes to teach the kids how to grow crops. And then later on, we'll see that they have a whole fucking field of crops and farming.
I gotta talk to my dad for a second. Grab us some food?
Yeah, on it.
Get me something con picante.
You get what you get.
And then, as far as the nutrients are concerned, I think they're pretty well prepped and pretty well
scar is on his knees, right?
Built for food. There's a freaking... This is a stadium. Like, if you've ever been to a stadium...
Nice to see you too, Abby.
I mean, you see them. In stadiums, you have your fryers and your grills, and you have everything you could possibly need.
You have to sharpen your knife.
So with them using the shit that's at the stadium, and then going out hunting, I mean, they're basically living nowadays with the correct butcher and the correct... no, that's really all you need is a butcher and stuff like that. And again, that huge library that they showed at the beginning, if you don't have a butcher, you can make one. Because you have books, so you can just read how to become a butcher, and presto changeo. And you could get whatever freaking nutrients you need, pots and pans, everything that they would need is right here, the protein amounts, all that good shit. They have it. It's available because they live in a fucking stadium. Concessions office is a whole nother thing. That you wouldn't have anywhere else other than a freaking stadium. You know what I'm saying? Like, they have a lot of shit because they overtook a stadium. And there's a large part of the stadium they're not even using it. What's over there? More places. Probably that used to sell popcorn or, see, that's a cafe right there. Stuff that they're not going to take advantage of because, well, although coffee is important, I guess it's not that important, unless you're Joe. But who knows what Joe traded for the coffee. Even he said it was a lot.
What are they serving today? Burritos. Again. Okay.
Abby, what are you doing?
Hey, tenemos prisa, dame tres burritos.
Hey, man, there's a line.
Kenny, what the fuck?
Excuse me.
Wait your turn like the rest of
Sorry.
Us.
We're going to the front. Come on.
So
now, with that said, seeing as
Why
how...
Why do you have three? Pull him back.
Now, don't freak out. Mel's coming with us.
They're eating fucking burritos.
Manny?
Where's your pack? In the room?
Why are you doing this to me?
Because I care about both of you. And I'm tired of all the bullshit.
Does she know I'm on this drive?
She does.
And she's cool with it?
Yeah.
Why does your yeah sound like a no?
It's my accent. Come on, stop being paranoid.
I think they could probably
make
coffee.
Out of making me uncomfortable.
No. It's an opportunity for you two to finally move forward.
We've barely said a word to each other since Jackson. I'm just supposed to pretend that didn't happen?
Of course not. You guys need to talk about it.
She wanted Joel dead as much as the rest of us.
but she's not like the rest of us. She hasn't hurt people like that before.
She kills Scars all the time.
Not the way we kill Joe. Don't forget, we are grunts. She's a medic. Come on, Abby. She's family. Do it for me, okay?
I'll try.
That's all I'm asking for.
And that was kind of like a fourth wall break to us, where the players that couldn't deal with Joe's death are Mel. And Abby saying shit like, she kills grunts, she kills Scars all the time, and, you know, she should get over it. That's kind of their way of telling us to fucking, you know, move on. When she was like, so we're just gonna forget about Jackson? And then Manny says, no, you should talk about it. It's more of, yeah, that discussion that everybody had about Joel being dead and it sucking and yada, yada, yada. Yeah, we need to discuss it because obviously Joel was important and everybody loves Joel and he was a father figure in video gaming and all that shit. So no, you're not expected to just forget about it and love Abby. You're expected to have a discussion about it. Not fucking lose your shit and fucking zeros all over the place. You know, and hopefully this helps with the discussion about it. Joe let his guard down. He was comfortable and he was older. And honestly, like when I think about that shit, I think it was very characteristic of Joe. When he was fucking shot in the leg and he was laying there, he didn't say, oh, don't kill me. He didn't say none of that shit. He basically spat at Abby's face and said, say your little speech and get this over with. He went out like a badass. Like, I don't think there's anything wrong with the way Joe went out. He was trying to be helpful. We have figured out throughout the show, the game, that certain people had tried to leave Jackson, like the teenagers and shit like that. And Joe kind of, he got a little soft. He got a little soft. And he was trying to help these randoms that he saw. And much like the teenagers, he thought to himself, well, maybe they could enjoy Jackson. And we also saw that there was people that lived in Jackson that weren't from there. And they were like, oh, man, it's going to suck to go back home after living here. So Jackson was a very welcoming community. Maybe they were wrong for that. That's true. But Joel, the character, I don't think there's anything that they can say, that somebody could say, oh, that's not the Joel I know. It's exactly the Joel you know. It's the same Joel. I don't think any of it was out of his character. He saw somebody that needed help. He helped them.
Get your things ready. I'm going to grab them.
Yeah.
That's probably why you loved them so much in the first place. He was never like a super prick, unwarranted, you know?
I'll do it later.
That kind of made me feel for her. I was like, man, I hate doing this just to Abby. I can relate. I was surprised that nobody grabbed the bra. Like, why didn't
scientist, huh?
Somebody said that. What's that supposed to mean? Because it's trying to say that scientists can't have red bras. I didn't see it that way. I think she was just like, oh, so that's who you banged. So this belongs to scientists. I didn't see it as if to mean scientists can't wear red bras. I'm pretty sure scientists can wear whatever color bra they want. And here is, like I said, crops. So I would imagine growing cocoa beans wouldn't be out of the question. The only real question would be, how would you get said cocoa beans? But other than that, I could see how they could make coffee here. Which, if they did make the coffee here, could mean that maybe Joe got the coffee from here, and it may be something that's something that he was embarrassed to tell Ellie how he got the coffee. Could have been information on his own whereabouts. Maybe Joe ratted himself out. I mean, that would be really stupid. But I wouldn't put it out of the question. Maybe he figured, fuck it, whoever's coming for me, come for me. You know, Joe's that much of a badass. I don't think he was going to back down from a fight. So I wouldn't have been surprised if he was just like, you give me coffee if I tell you where the fuck I am? Okay. And maybe that's where they got the lead. I wouldn't be surprised. I don't think Joe's going to be the type of guy to be like, oh, well, no, I'm not going to tell you where I am. I'm pretty sure Joe's like, I don't give a fuck. You know?
What's wrong?
Yeah, just about.
Like, fuck it. I pissed off a lot of persons. If they're going to come and get me, they may as well come and get me.
Hi.
You know?
Hey. I actually cleared you for active duty. Barely. You could probably get a stay if you ask.
I'd rather not sit around if I don't have to.
And Owen's okay with this?
Why would it be up to Owen? We need to grab Alice on our way.
Hey. Do better.
So is Manny there saying that maybe that's his baby? Oh, extra drama. Who knows? Maybe. I mean, it's not as if Mel has 100% said that's Owen's baby. And she did just say, why would it matter to Owen?
It's just the usual rotation, don't worry.
Hey, when you get back, will you check on my dad? He seems...
Maybe that's Manny's baby.
Worse?
Worse how?
Well, he's complaining about a sharp pain in his wrists.
We know he's a player.
He can barely hold his spoon.
Maybe we can get him some more painkillers.
Heard they moved you and Owen to Section 96?
Yeah, it's nice. It's lots of young families.
Getting you guys excited? About the baby?
Seeing all the kids running around, yeah, I'm getting ready.
All those crying babies? Let's drive Owen crazy.
He hasn't even seen it yet.
Yeah, so as far as like...
rotation with Danny.
Sports drinks and
Danny.
Protein
Yikes.
Bars and all Sucks that shit you would need to get rid of. I mean, all the ingredients seem to be here. They're fucking grilling. You know what I mean? Like, I'm pretty sure... she's smoking a cigarette, bro. That's a cigarette. I'm pretty sure there's more than enough evidence that that person is walking. That is a glitch. That is one of the first glitches I've seen. That is a real glitch. I haven't seen a glitch in this game yet. That's a glitch. That's a glitch. Can I fix it? And it's... oh, if that was coffee, I would have lost my shit. But it doesn't seem to be anything in there. But that is definitely a glitch. That is definitely a glitch. Onions... beets, corn on the cob. Yeah, I'm pretty sure her growth is justified. I don't see why she couldn't get swole. They seem to have everything they need. I don't even know what these are. Strawberries? Sacks of seeds. Laundry. That's the Odin way to do laundry, by the way. Used to do that back in Mexico when I was growing up. I mean, they got this shit, like, on lock and key, dude. They're doing laundry. You know what I mean? Like, they have everything that they would need. From what we saw in Jackson, they had meat. They had restaurants. They had weed. They had plants. They definitely had crops. But to this level, I don't think so.
Signing out, Alice?
She's playing inside.
Great. Abby, you want to grab her?
This is a whole nother level of...
Hey, girl.
Of society.
Hey, crazy dog.
There's my favorite girl.
The only one that'll put up with your shit.
Don't be jealous.
Hey, Al. You want to go to the trucks? Let's go to the trucks.
Oh, hey, vampire. Yeah, okay, since you asked so nicely.
Get it. And, like, I don't understand how some were, like, talking all that shit. And they were so mad at Abby that they didn't even play with the dog. Like, come on, man. Play with the dog. This is a Marvel video game. Look at him. Look at him. Look at him.
Get the ball.
It's fucking incredible. Look, he's just gonna follow me with the ball in his mouth. And he's not gonna drop the ball until I fucking stop. Look at him. Alright, now I stop. What the fuck? And I can pet
he's
him.
The best boy. Yeah.
Look at that. How do they program that shit? Now what if I run around with the ball in my head? Oh yeah, he follows me. Oh, he lost me for a second and he barked like a dog would. Now what if I bounce it off the wall?
Go get it.
He heard it bounce off the wall, so he goes and he checks the wall first. Let's do that again. Let's bounce it off the wall. Good boy. Now watch this. I overshot
Sorry,
it.
Buddy. My bad.
And he just sits there waiting for the dog like a good...
Did I see Miss Jen last night?
Yes, you did.
Are those sheep?
What's she doing in town?
Something for Isaac.
That's gotta be a lonely job.
Cows, chickens.
He likes it.
That's soccer ball?
Well, I guess you get to stay away from the combat.
Yeah, that's what you're into.
I'd be happy staying put, I think. Just treating families.
You'd miss fucking up scars.
I don't think so.
I'd go crazy.
Yep, this is a 10. Soccer ball minigame? Hell yeah. Fuck. Hold on. Shit, where'd it go? I gotta make that goal, come on. Oh, fuck! Okay. No! Goal! Goal, Abby! Goal! Alright. My window, I'm like, what the fuck is wrong with Abby? Playing soccer, hold on. Fuck.
Hey, Abby.
Hey.
Where is it? Oh, back here. shit. Did I lose it? Oh man, it's too far back now. But now I want to make it past that goal. Ooh, that was a good one. Shit. Man, I should buy a FIFA. Fuck! I thought that was gonna be it. Oh. Goal! Yes! Oh, is it stuck?
Hi,
Pat. Fuck, I think it's stuck now. Damn it. Well, I didn't notice that the first time around. That's pretty cool. They even have graffiti on themselves. Rest in peace. Also, this is like the memorial. Oh, wow. Check that out. It has all their names. Damn, that's crazy, dude. I didn't notice that the first time around. Wow. Naughty Dog Games, I swear. So much attention to detail. It's crazy.
Hey, Pat. Can I have my usual?
You got it.
Gracias.
Which trucks are in?
Take S-24.
I'm driving. Sign us out.
That's smart. So they use the holding cells where they would hold disorderly persons at the stadium as where they hold the guns and the keys to their automobiles. Shit, that's so fucking smart. Equipment locker. No, that's just where they would keep, like, I guess all the equipment for the stadium. It would have made more sense if they used the holding cells, but whatever.
I could use a warm-up.
So, again, why was Abby such a fucking crack shot? Well, let me get weapons first. Because they have a fucking gun range.
Some friendly competition?
The loser cleans the apartment.
High stakes. Best score on a full magazine?
You're on, cabrón.
That's why Abby's such a fucking crack shot. Yes, Abby, it's a post-apocalypse. It's pretty privileged to be a WLF.
I'm requesting that gun next time.
Yeah, the gun's why I won. Oh, that reminds me, there is a huge pile of dirty dishes.
You're cruel.
Ooh, you can fold my laundry, too. Let's get to the base.
More ammo if you two need it.
And then you can reload because these fuckers just have ammo up the ass. Look at all this ammo. How are they doing it? Oh, they're making it back there. You see that dude back there? They're fucking making it. On some Walking Dead shit. They're making ammo. So yeah, they're overpowered compared to Jackson. No question about it.
Yeah.
But is it out of the realm of possibility? No. The first thing they do is show you why they're so overpowered. And this guy's a fucking mechanic. They have a mechanic. Did they find one? They don't need to. They had a huge fucking library.
Alice, get shot done.
Mel's pregnant.
She could use the fresh air. Give you two a chance to talk.
Real settled, buddy.
Again, it's starting to seem like Manny is the person that got Mel pregnant.
Gracias.
Especially since he seems to be really cool with her enough to ask that she help out her dad, his dad.
Have you been sleeping these days? Not great. Do you want me to get you something from the pharmacy? Nah, I'm good. It's not a
pharmacy.
Big deal. No, it's fine. I'm just gonna wear myself out. I've been picking up a few extra assignments.
Dude, even more props. Look at that shit, man.
What do you mean?
Look at that shit!
Hey, Manny. Where are you headed?
Two.
Truck S-24 headed to two. Maybe survive will be long.
Maybe you're dead this way.
Hey, we lost a hatchery.
Yeah.
Any plan on getting it back?
Nah, Isaac says it's low priority. We're fishing up wild salmon right now.
And there in the background, you see the Seraphites
bridges. What do you mean about me and Owen?
That they build.
I haven't seen him in like 2 weeks. He keeps picking up open assignments. Did he talk to you? Did he say anything?
You got that one shot of the stadium from the outside.
Not.
Stadiums,
I mean,
are really massive.
I've seen him in the mess hall, but we walk around each other. Jackson shook me. You know, I wouldn't read too much into it.
Oh, shit! Ambush!
Hang on!
Mel, stay low!
Kill the wolves!
They were waiting for us. Yeah.
Take him out!
The fuck do you think we're doing?
Get closer! Bring him there!
Get him out of it!
Go, Fred! Go! Get around there!
Just keep coming!
Shit, that was a bad shot.
From the fog.
It's a hike.
We're too exposed. Let's get inside. It's clear. Come on.
Make sure this place is secure.
And that was action-packed for no reason. I kind of want to kill these. Oh, right. I'm fucking playing New Game Plus, so I have all my weapons. Nice. Really nice. Okay.
Hey, Abs. There's enough stuff here to make a pipe bomb.
Copy that.
We got this.
I haven't been to the swap meet in so long. That sounds nice though, don't it? Somebody posted that on Twitter when the game first came out. I still think it's funny. I'm envious if any of you ever had swap meet love. Like, I'm envious of you. I just want you to know that. I'm envious. I wish I had swap meet love. I never had that. And I don't think I'm going to, because like I feel like that's a very immature thing. Like, that's
the youngins. Hide in here.
Well, I guess I kind of did. Yeah, I kind of did. One of my first girlfriends, we went to a swap meet together, so I guess I kind of did. Those that had that when they were like really young, you know. But it's too bad.
Way out.
I'll climb up there and check it out. Here we go.
Oh, I've never gotten drunk and watched anime, so I can't say if this is better. That seems fun, I guess. But I don't like anime like that. Like, there was a couple that I liked, but I don't know. I'd rather play video games.
Hang on!
Guys!
Weapons to get through this. I just need to be careful. Stayed falling back. Hey, no, don't do that, will you?
Guys,
bullshit there. Survivor mode says one of them. Somebody's still out here. Where's that one girl? Where'd you run off to?
Fuck this place.
Yes.
Fuck this place. Come on.
Hey guys, I think I found a way out.
Oh, it left me right where I'm supposed to be. That's nice. Oh, there's a lot of stuff I didn't get for Abby, huh? Interesting. didn't do a lot for Abby, huh? That's interesting. I guess I just didn't care about her. I was just like, man, fuck Abby. I don't want to stop playing this game now that I've started. It's such a good game.
Manny,
you got it.
I need to stop.
Ladies first.
Yeah, he tapped that.
Another month and I wouldn't fit through here.
Go ahead, Apps.
He said ladies first.
I like you.
He was already trying to hook up with Abs too. Fucking mujeriego.
Okay.
That means player in Spanish.
Abby, this reminds me of your dad's greenhouse. Shouldn't. All these plants
but
are
not
alive.
Not really, because I feel like player means that you play with women's emotions.
You know what?
This whereas a mujeriego is just a guy that has a lot of girls.
Shut up, Manny.
Working already.
As if they knew I was going to be like, well, actually.
Another one?
Yep.
Hey, I know a good drinking game. You can play with those.
Maybe later.
Yeah, see, he's trying. You better make sure she's fucking consenting, though. Talking about drinking game, bro. She'll fuck you up. You see the pipes on this girl? Well, not that it would matter, though. If we're going to fuck you up, she'll fuck you up. It don't matter if you got pipes or not. Girl's crazy, dude. You don't even know. And even the ones that, like, aren't crazy, even the ones that are like, oh, no, I would never. Bro. They'll find a way, bro. Trust me. Well, he was probably talking about playing quarters. Like, you know, when you put, like, alcohol into a cup, and then you try to flip the quarter in there, and if you land it, then the other person has to drink it. And if you miss it, then they try to land it, and whoever lands the quarter, it has to bounce off the table, though. You have to bounce it off the table, and then it has to land in the beer. And then if it lands, you gotta drink that fucking beer. That's how you play quarters. That's a drinking game. There's a lot of drinking games. That's like a broke version of beer pong, really, when you think about it. Because beer pong is basically the same principles, but you have actual balls and teams and shit. So, like, beer pong is just a more not ghetto version of quarters. I never thought about it that way, but yeah. Basically, that's all it is.
Pop said ahead.
No scars in sight.
Well, they're out there.
Yeah. Let's keep moving. God. Remember when we were getting jumped by scars?
Nothing stands out. This is way more bright than most of what this game is, but it's still not too offensive. It does hurt my eyes a bit because this is really bright. But it's not as bright as Ghost of Tsushima. But yeah, this is kind of offensive. This kind of hurts my eyes.
Getting nostalgic about the truce? Easy days, huh?
Too easy. We let our guard down.
That was in retaliation to us shooting
the Okay, but those kids attacked our guys. What would you do?
I don't know, not riddle them with
I'd rather save our
Not our fault either. These deaths are on them.
Heartless. I don't know, man. I think kids are like a different. Like, if they're kids, you know what I mean? Like, kids are dumb. I feel like kids You need to give kids some leeway, because they're kids, man, you know? Even with something like that, I think, oh, you fucking dumbass kid. And that's saying something, because, like, I think nowadays, the death penalty, even if you're a kid, they'll charge you for life. But when I was growing up, kids used to get away with that shit.
But it is very quiet out of here.
Back in the day, it would be like, oh, you're a fucking kid. But I think they changed that recently. But I'm still of the belief that kids are dumb, and you gotta excuse them. I mean, obviously you shouldn't fucking commit murder, but kids are dumb. They can't help it.
We need to be on the other side of this fence. Cut through one of the buildings?
Because that worked out so well last time.
Do you have another idea, Manny?
No, just venting.
Manny, see what's up there.
On it.
And just so that we're clear, I'm still a kid, so I should get away with a lot. Thank you very much.
The cable's cut on something. There you go. Come on up.
Mel, stay with Alice. I'll try to get that door open. Find you two another way in.
Cool. Be careful.
Okay, and I'm going to end the stream here.
Well,
still no sign of scars.
This is the best part of the game. If you're like me... Hey, wait. Can I jump up? No. You still had some hatred in your heart for Abby. Then I suggest you do this. One of my favorite parts of the game. And plus, you could just keep doing it. Ooh. That looks like it hurts. I want to get one where she bangs her fucking head off of it, though. What? Oh, God, that's sick. But at least Abby's not a real person, so I don't feel that bad about watching it over and over again. Abby's not real. Oh, yeah, that's it. That's it. That's enough. All right, well, thank you for watching. Fiona Apple. I will see y'all next time. Peace.